Hello everyone, I'm Jensen, your digital content producer. It is Wednesday, August 5th, and I'm about to get you all caught up on today's top headlines. So we're gonna take a look at what the heck is happening with OSU's football schedule this year, plus there are some changes to Governor Mike DeWine's regularly scheduled press conference, and Ohio's about to get a visit from President Donald Trump. But before we dive into all of that, I actually wanna get you up to speed on the latest coronavirus data. So, today, there have been 1,199 new cases of the virus, but that is shy of the 21-day average of 1,285. Unfortunately, there were 26 new coronavirus-related deaths, but that's only one above the 21-day average of 25. Hospitalizations are slightly up as well with 112 new admissions, but the ICU admissions number is staying around the same at 16, which is one below the 21-day average. But now let's talk a little bit about what's happening with schools. As a reminder, Governor Mike DeWine did issue a mask order for K-12 students returning to the classroom, but Lucas County could actually be taking that a step further. Last week, the Lucas County Board of Health President, Dr. Jonathan Ross, recommended that schools start the year virtually and that they hold back on fall sports until we get a hold on the virus, as long as we get it under control. And tomorrow, the health department is actually set to hold a special meeting to discuss all of this at 2:30, during which they're expected to kind of solidify guidance going forward. And that could lead to some changes for districts that have already put forth their plan, many of which have enacted some form of in-person learning. But TPS has already decided that they're going to start the year completely virtual, and they're pushing back fall sports until at least October 1st, where they can kind of reassess the situation. Plus, Ottawa Hills has reached out to parents, letting them know that some changes could be made, and their Board of Education has decided to meet tomorrow after the health department to look at their back to school plans, and they're going to be talking about school levy requests for the November 3rd ballot. But I want to pivot here a bit, as there have been some developments in the world of collegiate sports. The Big Ten released its 10-game conference-only football schedule, which is set to begin as early as Labor Day weekend. But don't get too excited just yet. Organizers are saying there's no certainty that any games will actually be played. Just a month ago, the Big Ten announced it would be shortening the season to eliminate non-conference games because of the pandemic. Under the revised schedule, teams will be playing conference opponents they were originally set to meet and will only have one additional cross game. But since we're in Ohio, I wanted to see what was up for our Buckeyes this year. So here's a full schedule behind me, but we have all of that on our website right now too if you need a closer look. Ohio State will open the season against Illinois on the road Thursday, September 3rd. And if you're wondering about the big game against the Wolverines, that is scheduled to take place at Ohio Stadium on October 24th. The regular season starts the weekend of September 5th and runs through November 21st. And November 28th is a uniform open date. The 10 games will be played over at least 12 weeks, with each team having two open dates for a total of three. If need be, makeup games could be played during bye weeks. But if the coronavirus situation causes some shakeups, the season could start September 12th or the 19th or the 26th. The Big Ten Championship game in Indianapolis is still scheduled for December 5th, but that could be moved to as late as the 19th. Clear as day, right? And I have to reiterate that these things are all tentative. In a statement released right alongside this schedule, Ohio State Athletic Director Gene Smith said a final decision has yet to be made regarding whether or not the Big Ten will even move forward with the 2020 campaign. The conference is continuing to consult with experts about the coronavirus, and they said they'll make a final decision in the weeks ahead. So stay tuned with us. We'll keep you updated as soon as we get official word. And when it comes to Ohio bars, if you were hoping the new restriction on alcohol sales would be deemed illegal, unfortunately, that is not the case. Several Columbus bars filed suit against Governor Mike DeWine and the Ohio Liquor Control Commission for their order requiring bars and restaurants to end the sale of alcohol at 10 p.m. And drinks have to be finished by 11 p.m. Judge Kim Brown ruled today that that rule would remain in effect. The suit also named the Ohio Department of Public Safety, which oversees the Ohio Investigative Unit, and that's the agency that handles all of the citations against the businesses that aren't in compliance. The attorney for the businesses in this case called the ruling arbitrary, discriminatory, and unreasonable. But defense attorneys said Wednesday that health professionals prefer the bars to be closed. So That is that. And in case you are already prepping for another daily dose of DeWine tomorrow, his regularly scheduled afternoon press conference has been moved instead to Friday at 2 p.m. Why, you may ask? Oh, just because Ohio is getting a visit from President Donald Trump. President Trump is set to visit the Whirlpool facility in Clyde tomorrow, although the exact time of his arrival has yet to be announced. This is his first visit to Ohio since the onset of the pandemic and his 16th trip to the state overall. He's set to tour the plant and speak about his administration's dedication in supporting the manufacturing industry and American-made products. The president is also set to attend a charity event in Cleveland tomorrow, and he'll be greeted by Governor DeWine once he lands here in the state. We'll have full coverage of his visit tomorrow on our website, WTOL.com, and in our broadcasts at 5, 6, and 11 p.m. So check that out if you are curious about what he has to say. And that's all I have for you today. If you have questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. You can always text us, too, at 419-248-1100. And catch us on air tonight. Again, those times are 5, 6, and 11. Check back with me tomorrow for another quick look at the day's top headlines. Until then, have a happy Wednesday.